Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. This is Emma and Georgia, and today we are watching Bridgerton Season 2, Episode 8. If you want to watch our uncut reaction, the link to the Patreon is down below.
We've reached the final episode of Bridgerton Season 2. I am excited because I think this means that Kate and Anthony are finally going to get together. But I'm also sad because I've enjoyed this season so much and now we have to wait months or year, singular, for the next one.
Pretty much. I know, we've literally only got one episode of Anthony and Kate really being themselves, to be honest. It's kind of really bittersweet because, you know, I wish we had more of them. I wish this season would go to episode 10, you know, to give us two more episodes.
Because as much as like we love a season of Bridgerton, you never know if you're gonna love the next one because they're completely different.
Exactly. And you know, we loved Daphne and Simon last season and we got hardly any of Daphne this season and no Simon, so
yeah.
I'm kind of hoping we do get Kate and Anthony next season because, you know, that'd be a real shame because I really like them too.
They are confirmed to be coming back, so there's something.
That's something, but if they're actually together a lot, that's a whole other thing because it'll be focused on that couple that season.
So last episode, Lady Danbury and Lady Bridgerton hatched a few plans to try and get their reputation back intact, and both families had to kind of work together in different scenarios in order to make that happen. Anthony and Kate were told to stay apart, but of course they couldn't. Anthony was going feral over Kate's lily soap.
Oh my god! Literally, the guy was unhinged. Every time she like brushed past him, he'd get a big whiff of the lily soap, and everyone around them would just, because they now know that there is something there, they're catching on a lot more. When Anthony and Kate were standing next to each other, they were sort of like touching, sort of, and Edrina looked over and she was like, have I been this blind? Yes. Yeah. Yes, you have, because this is what they were like. No one noticed.
I don't know how the actor managed to pull a straight face while doing that very intense whiff, because it was
literally
so
funny. It was the creepiest thing I've ever seen.
One of my favourite scenes so far was the ball scene where turned up because of the scandal that Lady Whistledown revealed about Eloise going to the dark alleyways and hanging out with political rascals. They all kind of just embraced it and had a dance together, and they brought Hyacinth and Gregory out, and it was just a fun time.
It was literally so wholesome. Like, both those families have been through it the past week of their lives, and I think this night, to just forget about that and just have a little sing song and dance, it was needed for both of them, even though there was no one else. But to be honest, all the other families are very prudish and snooty. I wouldn't want them there anyway. But yeah. I think this night was needed for them.
It still doesn't fix their reputation, and in fact it's been tarnished more, but they at least had a nice night together and they all got along, even just for one song.
Yeah, and I think it was Lady Danbury that said this, I can't remember who it was, but this won't last long, it will be soon forgotten when a new piece of gossip comes out. This shunning won't last. I highly doubt that. I think something else will come out.
And then obviously Kate and Anthony got very hot and heavy in the garden, which had us quaking.
That was unexpected. Let's just say that. Their arguments soon turned to just love, and it's that very fine line.
I feel like most people watching that are probably like, oh yes, they're having sex, and we're there like, but someone's gonna walk in though.
It's literally out in the open. Parents are literally like in the next building. That's so risky.
And then at the very end, they had very different responses. It was very fight or flight from both of them. Kate was flight and rode off on her horse, and then Anthony was fight and he chased after her with a ring. It was a rainy day. Kate tried to jump over something very high that her horse couldn't manage, and she fell off and potentially hit her head on a rock. We are still unsure whether she did or not.
It looked like it from where I was watching, you know, because she sort of flopped against it, I suppose, but hope she's all right, and I'm sure she will be. I think it was just a nasty fall.
Oh god.
Straight where we left off. What are you doing? Standing there, bruh.
Stay with me, come on now.
Oh, ew.
Yeah, she hit her head, ew. I knew it.
I suppose they didn't have phones back then. I was thinking call 999.
Call the ambulances.
Still shivering. Allow me to get to work.
He really does care for her.
I'm so scared of her dying.
Literally, he's shown more compassion to Kate in those minutes than he ever gave to Edwina.
It's my fault.
No.
Obviously he's going to take the blame for it.
He always puts everything on his shoulders.
Lord Featherington and I would like to give a ball.
A ball? Oh,
yeah. So that we may finally celebrate our engagement.
So that we may finally celebrate all of us.
I'm happy they have the means to hold a ball, but they should probably save, I think.
I know.
You apparently do not seem to take note of them either, since I spent the last 2 days balancing our books, only to discover that you seem to have taken out a rather large sum.
I was exploring an investment with Lord Featherington.
This is just what makes for difficulties in this household. No one gives any thought as to how it must be managed.
He's 1 in 20, brother.
One in 20, okay.
So are we.
You have not been to see her? It has been a week.
Have I not made it clear that I've been busy?
Trying to take your mind off it more light.
I do not have time for this.
Perhaps you might wish to make time.
Time is of the essence. At least Edwina's sitting by her bedside.
I know, I'm surprised actually, but I guess she put her grudges aside, as it is her sister that's dying currently. Oh, it's gonna be from Theo though, surely.
Has he sent her a book?
Yes!
Why did you continue lying to me, carrying on with me, when you knew this entire time that the real Lady Whistledown has been using this very shop to print her scandal sheet?
I couldn't tell you. God. Why do you think I ended things the way I did with you, despite wanting to do the very opposite?
Oh!
Ooh.
Sounds like a confession to me.
I didn't want her to write cruelly of you.
A little late for that.
Manuscripts came early mornings. Twice a week, usually.
Do you have the wrapping they came in?
They never came in wrapping. They came sewn into silks.
Mr. Bridgerton, you cannot be entertaining any of this in earnest. The man is a swindler.
I beg your pardon, ma'am.
Are you actually telling him?
It is a trait he seems to share with his late cousin. Someone I myself became involved with and whose unscrupulous actions I once mistakenly condoned.
Oh. The Featheringtons are a fine family whose reputation has been most unfairly traduced. I would be very careful of the accusations you make in future, as it hardly seems you can afford to drive away any more patrons.
Colin, I love you sticking up for Penelope's family, but he was looking out for you.
Every time. Colin literally backs the wrong side every time. Literally, it happened with Lady Crane.
Colin Bridgerton has taken the bait.
You may have allowed me to move into my bedchamber, my lord, but that does not mean you can just burst in unannounced.
I could have been undressing!
Do not tell me you have no plan of escape, my lord.
Did they not think about this?
We leave London.
We go back to the Americas.
Travel to the Americas. Endless opportunity, endless wealth for us to secure together. Portia, we could be an even better team.
Are you kidding me?
You could be their queen.
Oh my god, this is actually just curse. Ew! No! No!
Think about it.
She was like pouncing.
She was ready for it.
Edwina.
Mama! Lady Danbury, make haste!
Make haste! Make haste!
Do you remember?
I remember riding in the
I remember riding Lord Bridgerton.
Can you imagine she said that?
Lord Bridgerton come to see me.
He?
Oh.
He rescued you in the park.
And since? I see.
No, you don't say, Kate.
Anthony.
She's awake.
She's awake.
Mrs. Wilson heard from one of the maids.
Make haste!
Make haste, Anthony! Oh my god! He's actually showing emotion!
Oh my god!
I'm so sorry that it was you who was with your father that day. I am
sorry for everything that happened in the days.
Of course, they're doing this now.
They have to.
If I could go back and change that, you have no idea how much I wish I could change everything.
It did kind of mess him up.
I can see her.
Losing Edmund was the most difficult time of my life.
But being with him must have been the happiest.
Beyond description. I would still choose the life I led with him each and every time. Real, true love is worth it.
Yes! Preach! You found the one, Anthony! Come on!
It would be foolish of me to be engaged with such a scandalous person. As foolish as it is for you to be poking around like this, when I know what Whistledown recently wrote of you.
This is getting really bad for Penelope. Eloise is going to find out real soon.
You're not listening to me. I'm going to find her now.
Do not scream at me.
Oh no. Not another fight.
Who is talking?
Servants.
Completely making this up.
My sister asked me about it just the other day.
This scandal of yours will soon pass. I look forward to the day when things will return to how they used to be between us.
Penelope, what is this? Oh, she might as well just tell Eloise. She's going to find out eventually.
I think many of us at the Academy assumed you'd be all drink and no paint.
Why ever would they assume that?
Considering your acceptance. How it was based on, well, you know, your brother's large donation to the Academy. That's what secured your place.
Really?
I thought you knew.
Oh my god, the whole time he thought he actually earned his place. Oh, that's so sad.
Lord Bridgerton.
Oh my gosh. You don't need to make haste, Kate.
Thank you for the flowers.
It's a little awkward between them now. Come on, Auntie, say something.
Was there something else, my lord?
Propose.
Whoa, that was really close to my ear hole.
I call on you to apologise. You deserved so much more than that. I took liberties.
I did not want it to happen like that.
I would have too.
I came to apologise.
Yes, you already said that.
And to ask you to marry me.
Yes!
I'm asking you.
No, my lord, I do not need you to ask me anything at all.
Kate.
I'm returning to India.
Don't!
The moment I resolve matters with my sister, I'm returning to India. It is decided.
Undecided then, Kate.
Actually, you gotta come up with something better than that. That was too haste. Too much haste.
You are running away.
Yes.
She is.
Please go.
She's running away from her problems. Stop it.
Allow yourself to love, Kate.
No, not the
first one. Oh my goodness. Oh, they are touching.
Oh, please.
So.
Forgive me.
We cannot continue to meet like this.
This was your idea.
You know, I know it was. And I'm sorry for wasting your time.
You should have known. But you cannot be any different from all other ladies.
No! I fear he may not be in the next season. Please tell me the actor is confirmed.
Actor, make haste.
I want to know myself truly and to know who you are too. Whatever action you now wish to take, I only hope it is because you are being truthful to yourself.
I think that's like her little blessing.
A near-death experience always puts things in perspective.
Literally.
Brother?
Oh my goodness.
Should you not be in bed?
These
two? Yelled at me.
Oh.
Stupid.
That's not professional conduct.
Martin Tudor does not think you are stupid. He thinks I am frightening.
Father.
I suppose he never met him, did he?
He was like both of us, really. He had my seriousness, perhaps.
I wish I could have played a prank on him.
It's always so emotional when the father's brought up.
I know.
Oh God, now she's listening in.
That is because I have shown up far too late for far too many things.
Oh.
It's good for a laugh, of course, but courageous.
I love this growth from Anthony, that now he's willing
literally,
to open up.
He's just so hard and prideful, and now he's breaking down his barriers and being there for his family on an emotional level, which he previously wasn't.
Eloise. Thank you for protecting me.
You are a true friend.
Oh, this hurts.
Oh, she's gonna eat her words once she knows.
That's the right speak of Lord Fife. I hear he recently spent a good deal of time with Miss Goring in a closet, for what I cannot imagine.
Penelope, I think you might be exposing yourself. Oh,
that was a keen observation, Pen.
Oh my god.
Did she just out herself?
I think so.
Eloise literally looks like she's seen a ghost. Oh god, I'm scared now. She knows.
Because I don't think she's ever gossiped before. She's always kept it to herself.
Might we take to the dance floor?
With whom? Ourselves?
Whoa.
They cannot possibly say anything about us that we have not heard before.
Breaking traditions, I love it.
Yeah. Colin and Cressida?
Ew! What are you doing, Colin?
I enjoy that beautiful necklace you're wearing. A gift from Lord Featherington.
Colin.
17 rubies, in fact.
Oh, is he getting a closer look? Oh my goodness! Holy shit! They're in a room alone together!
Your cousin, Lord Featherington, I'm sorry to be the one to tell you this, Pen, but... Well, I have looked into him.
Oh.
I believe he is nothing but a mere charlatan.
What?
That this necklace is a fraud. Made of glass. Just like you. It is out of concern for their reputation alone that I will only address this matter in private. But I expect you to return all of the funds you have collected and leave town at once.
Go on, Colin!
What about my young ladies?
We shall send for them after.
After? After what?
After what?
Well, they can come with us.
He just wants to get away with her, doesn't he? Ah! Oh my god! This is insane!
We are dancing.
Oh! Yes! Finally, I've been waiting for this!
I had been rehearsing that speech in my mind for hours. We'll always look after you, Penelope.
Stop!
Oh, you're special.
Jesus!
Why is he so cute this up?
This is so cute!
Oh,
I swear,
off.
Colin doesn't even realise what it means.
We should continue to keep our distance between us in light of the...
Perhaps we should not.
Oh.
Perhaps I needed someone to steady me. So you were the first person I found.
What is it?
Three. Are you going to ask me to dance?
Spit it out, come on!
One last time? Why is she still leaving? Come on!
I know, Anthony needs to convince her fully!
Oh, I know this song. Is it Wrecking Ball?
Oh my goodness, it is!
Ooh.
Just keep looking at me.
As always.
Nothing else matters.
Oh my god, has everyone stopped dancing? Oh, this is really awkward now.
I think they look beautiful together.
Oh! Beautiful.
Go on, Edwina!
Do they not?
Oh my god!
Have I yet told you about my nephew?
Is
that Prince Friedrich?
No.
Prince Friedrich was her nephew, wasn't he?
Bring Prince Friedrich back! We've got an eligible
jokes.
Lady! Possibly, Edwina could score herself a prince of, you know, the queen.
Yeah, better than a Viscount.
Yeah, it's better than a Viscount.
He definitely smelled! Has she found her floorboard?
Eloise. When I expressed my dislike for the naming of the diamond at the beginning of the season, Whistledown disavowed the whole thing shortly after.
Ooh.
How you were one of the only people who could have known about Miss Thompson's pregnancy. The only person you were interested in saving was yourself. Also, you could keep making money at a cost to everyone else.
You have no idea how horrible it's felt to keep this from you. From everyone. For so long, I wrote what I wrote and I gave it up for you.
An insipid wallflower, indeed.
All you ever do is
you might as well get out now.
About doing something. You have all these great ambitions, these great plans, but I am the one who actually did something great, and you cannot stand it, can you?
I can't believe this was the episode it comes out.
I know. That was so much worse than their fight last season.
This seems permanent.
I gave a memorable farewell party for you.
Oh.
Oh, she's getting rid of him.
Never touch me again.
Because you dismissed her daughters, that's why.
Stating that as soon as one of my girls has a son, the estate shall pass to them.
But yes!
Excellent penmanship, you see.
But what do they do for money in the meantime? Like, do they have that much?
You are cruel.
I am a mother.
Oh!
Oh my god!
Bad bitch! Now what is she gonna do with the guests that are in the garden?
I thought she was going to have like a little firework display or something.
Penelope Featherington, the way you were dancing with her looked rather interesting. You're courting the girl, Bridgerton.
Ah, are you mad? I would never dream of courting Penelope Featherington. Not in your wildest fantasies, Fife.
Colin!
Colin!
Colin! What the?
What the hell was that disrespect?
You love your family dearly.
As much as you love yours.
So combine them.
I was fearful of losing you. It is why I could not visit you after your accident. I love you. I've loved you from the moment we faced each other in that
God.
Park. I've loved you at every
dance. This is what I've been waiting
every
for.
Walk, every time we've been together and every time we've been apart, you do not have to accept it. You do not have to embrace it. Or even allow it. Knowing you, you probably will not. But you must know it. You must feel it because I do.
Oh!
Jesus! You can't go to India after this.
She needed those words.
I do not think there is anything else to say.
Just stay.
Other than I love you too.
Yeah.
Oh my god, this is perfect. There
will never be a day where you do not vex me.
Is that a promise, Kathani Sham?
Oh, there is fireworks.
Oh, yes.
It seems the two of us are finally seeing eye to eye on something.
Suppose we
are. Oh my god! This is perfect! It's yes. A shame it lasted all the way into the end.
I know, the slowest of burns. It's like a Disney film.
Literally.
I must apologize for how I acted the other day. It was what I needed to do in order to gain his trust.
A win I do not relish.
Perhaps you should pour yourself something as well.
He's going business!
I yes. told him this place was run by an honorable man.
I'm still mad at him, but I love this. Thank
you. You do know my duties are particularly important to me.
Seems so very dutiful.
My god, their sexy talk is very odd.
They're happy.
I never mind see the day.
But left the mallet of death.
For me! Oh. Never mind.
Probably keep to pink, Anthony. Rather think that it will match the shade of your embarrassment when you use it.
I just want to take this opportunity to return upstairs.
Anthony!
And admit defeat.
Jesus, they cannot keep their hands off each other, but this was what Daphne and Simon were like.
It must be so weird seeing him in love for them.
I know! He's literally like a changed man now.
Oh, it's like a fairy tale.
It literally is! Also, that means that Edwina is now Anthony's, like, sister-in-law, which is kind of odd.
Stop!
They got their happy ending!
Oh!
Oh my god! What a finale!
I'm so happy. I mean, to be honest, I thought Kate and Anthony would get together at the start of the episode, not the last 10 minutes.
Honestly, the one thing I really don't like about this episode, well, it's not the only thing that I don't like, is the fact that it took, even this episode, so long to get them together. Like, they had, like, fleeting moments throughout, but the ending is where it really happened.
Yeah, that bothers me a bit, but I also liked the stories we got in the episode. Like, we got
Yeah, it
everyone.
Wasn't just about them. It was about everyone. Yeah. Literally. And even the freaking Lady Featherington and Cousin Jack literally got a moment.
Can't like, believe they've kissed before pulling.
Don't even get me started. Where to begin? Freaking Colin infuriates me so much. The slowest of slow burns. He's literally What's wrong with him? I swear he likes Penelope. Now why is he bragging to his mates?
I don't think he likes her though. He likes her as a friend, so therefore I don't know why he said it like that. That was horrible. But I don't think he either doesn't have romantic feelings for her yet, or I don't think he realizes he has them. I think like that conversation with Marina is like sparking the journey to romance, but I'm not sure if he's there yet.
What he said was not even friendly. It was just,
I know,
awful. Like, not even on romantic friendly way, he literally just bashed Penelope into the soil. What was he exactly? He said like, I would never go for Penelope Featherington,
yeah,
or something.
I wouldn't
like
dream of courting Penelope Featherington.
Like, even as a friend, like, you joke about stuff like that, I suppose, but even that was really hurtful. And surely Colin isn't this blind to see how much Penelope adores him.
You shouldn't say stuff like that as a friend. You should stick up for them. Like, they were laughing at them while they were dancing. I don't know if you saw, but
yeah, they were.
He's clearly trying to fit in with the lads. You know, it's typical men boy behavior. He's only 1 and 20 after all. She is still his friend. He should stick up for her and say, so what if I was? What would be the problem with that? Like,
I know. Colin, be a man.
I love what he did with Mr. Mondridge though, the fact that he did believe him instantly and therefore investigated it, but he's got some making up to do with Penelope. I'm still excited for next season regardless.
I swear, if it's as slow as this burn this season, I'm just gonna start ripping my hair out in frustration. Like, this season with Anthony and Kate I thought was a very slow burn, so if theirs is even more, oh god forbid, like I'm just gonna be so frustrated the whole time waiting for things to happen, but backtrack all the time.
I think it will be a slow burn. But I love a slow burn, to be honest, because when it's a slow burn, I find it more in, so if we compare like Daphne and Simon with Kate and Anthony, Daphne and Simon got married in episode 5, so they obviously were not a slow burn. But I prefer slow burns because at least the drama all comes beforehand and then they're happy after. I don't like it as much when a couple gets together early on and then the drama comes after, because then that's when it starts getting into toxicity levels that I don't like.
That is true, actually. Yeah, I do firmly like Anthony and Kate more than Daphne and Simon because of the journey they've been on. The slow burn really helped Kate and Anthony out, like, develop their story, but it's just such a shame we didn't see much of them in this episode. Like, literally skip the wedding. I wanted to see the wedding and Edwina as a bridesmaid. I wanted that wedding, like Edwina's wedding. It was the drama.
We still got them happy, and I really like the contrast. If we think, like, the first time we saw Anthony in season 1, episode 1, I think, was he was shagging Sienna up against a tree, and he was like checking his watch because he had to go somewhere for a family like meeting or whatever. And then in this episode, it's come full circle where he's there, you know, shagging Kate, and he's like, oh, I want to go again. And she's like, no, your family's waiting.
Yeah, literally, that's so funny. He's such a changed man. Like, seeing him so carefree with his family is so good to see, because we've been waiting for it. His little moment with Gregory as well was so lovely.
Yeah.
That was such a lovely moment. I think that was one of my favourites, because we've never seen Gregory bond with one of the older brothers in the show before, and seeing Anthony with one of the youngers that we don't see, and it was really nice, you know, like, we don't see that, and it was such a touching moment.
Like, they do really well with those one-on-one emotional moments, especially with regards to Anthony, because there's something that hits so much harder about seeing someone that's so closed off finally opening themselves up and talking about their emotions with people.
Literally, it's a beautiful thing. You don't see it often, and Anthony's such a closed book, so prideful, and just does what he's supposed to do for his family and his duties.
Yeah.
And to seeing him flourish this episode, something so different than we're used to, was so nice. And it was just so nice to see, and I hope it carries on next season. We see Anthony with the family more, and smiling, laughing, dancing, whatever it is that but he just has a good time.
He is still the Viscount and he still has all his duties.
Oh, of course, yeah.
I think he will find a balance between... Because he would always say, oh, I don't have time to visit Kate, or I don't have time to do this and that or whatever, but you can still be a busy man and make time for your family. And now that he's got Kate in his life, he will want to spend time with her and everything. Yeah. So he'll become better in all aspects.
Well, he has other duties at the moment to fulfill, if you catch my drift.
I do.
I want to see more of them.
Dears, we'll probably be over them next season.
Probably, but yeah, for now I want more of them.
Also, I have just googled and it said on, because I can google Bridgerton now, and it says on Prince Friedrich's Wikia page, during Lady Featherington's ball, the Queen talked to Edwina Sharma about Prince Friedrich. She told her that he is still available.
Oh my god, it is actually Prince Friedrich. That is so funny.
Yeah, so all our mentions weren't for nothing.
Oh my god, bring him back. This is excellent news. I shipped him and Daphne because I just like him. I think he's a good guy, you know.
How is he still available?
I know. How is he still available? There must be something wrong with him. Him and Edwina would be an excellent pairing, I think, because she's very kind-hearted. And I think he is. He's very considerate of the people he courts.
And another thing that I really loved about Edwina especially, besides the fact that she got over Kate and Anthony after the near-death experience and all that, because, you know, that puts things in perspective, but I loved how she changed. Like, she said to Kate, I want you to be yourself and make choices for yourself and I will do the same. And we saw that Edwina this whole season has been acting, you know, a certain way, the way Kate has always trained her to be the perfect potential bride. And then there, the real her has a more rebellious side. Like, she pulled Kate to dance, two ladies dancing together. Whoa. Like, she doesn't really care what other people think.
No, this is really cool. Like, Edwina really stepped into her own this episode. Like, she dropped the anger and I think it turned to acceptance. And that near-death experience really put things into perspective for her, that she really does care for her sister despite, you know, men troubles. And she put that aside and she was like, you know what, we're gonna stay sisters and we're gonna actually know each other, not for the fake people that we've been acting. We're gonna be true to ourselves and preach it, because that is incredible mindset to have.
I've just googled and I'm a bit sad. It says, with regards to the actor who plays Theo, it says he is open to returning and he believes Theo and Eloise should be together, but nothing has been confirmed yet.
Oh. That is a shame. I felt so sad for their ending. Him and Eloise could have been a really nice match. Like, you know, the woman upper class mixing with lower class scandal. Like, that's a great storyline, you know?
Yeah.
I feel sad for that. And obviously, we do have to talk about freaking Penelope and Eloise. Shit, their friendship is in the shits right now. Like, I can't believe Eloise put two and two together this episode. I thought it would stretch out even more. I can't believe she figured it out. And she tore Penelope's room apart and they had the big argument. And I can't believe she finally knows. Literally, Penelope's been lying to her so long.
I did think that someone would find out this season, and then Madame Delacroix did, and I thought, oh, it must be her then. I can imagine Penelope going a whole season solo again. But Eloise, I like the way she did figure it out, the way Penelope did something that was out of character, because she's held in gossip for so long so that she can utilize it in her writing, and then her just becoming a gossip all of a sudden was like, well, what? But next season, obviously, we're going to see, I don't really know how much of it is going to come about, because Colin isn't really in the season. He like dips his toe in every now and then. He comes to the balls and he does a couple dances here and there, but he's never really participated properly. So I wonder if next season he is going to, or if him and Penelope just start naturally, like with their friendship and whatnot. And then Eloise as well. how that's going to be incorporated and how they make up, I don't know either, because Penelope won't be going to the Bridgerton house as much.
I know, it's going to be weird how they carry this on. Like, there's a lot of unfinished business, and, you know, it's tricky. How are they going to do this? And I'm really intrigued to see that.
It's a very interesting choice that they've chosen to move Colin and Penelope's story up in the books, because from this episode, I would think it's a good segue into Benedict's story, because he's leaving art school now. Like, maybe he would just decide to participate in the season. Whereas Penelope, there's now all these things to resolve with Colin and Eloise. I don't know how the season will start. The season's going to start in such turmoil with all the relationships.
Will Colin find out about Penelope as Lady Whistledown? Is Eloise going to tell him?
I always think of it as Penelope's season, not Colin's. It's going to be focused on Colin more, probably, because he's the Bridgerton of it all.
Yeah, I swear if Lady Crane comes back, I do not want that.
That's it for today, guys. Thank you for watching our reaction to Season 2, Episode 8 of Bridgerton. If you want to watch our uncut reactions to Bridgerton, the link to the Patreon page will be in the description below. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and we'll see you next time. Bye!
Bye!